Welcome back to the Google Apps in Teaching and Learning. So in the last video we saw how to create Google site, a web page in Google site, and add the contents to the Google site. Now we'll see how to add more pages to your website. So in the last video we saw all these insert menu. So in insert menu you can add various content as per the requirement. Now we'll see how to add a page. Now when you click on the page tab, you'll see you have by default a home page. So there is only one page, and this is what is your landing page that you can share with the users. So this becomes your home page. Now you can add few more pages to your website. Say for example, I'll add a new page here. Done. So module 1 will become a new page. So here you can see the home link is appearing, and then you'll have module 1. So this is your menu. So you can click on the menu, and by clicking on the menu you can navigate through those pages. So module 1 is, say for example, so you can drag and increase the text box for aligning the text. Now we will add some content here. So on module 1, so again adding the content is same. Go to the insert menu, click on the object that you want to insert. So whether you want to have a text box, you want to have an image, or you want to have some file from the Word document, or you need some template. So here we will add some content. Say for example, we'll take this, we'll add this layout. Now I want to add some video to this, so introduction to Google. So click on this, again go to YouTube. Now here you can see there are two options, video search. So we saw how to search a video. So you need to get a link of the video that you want to display in this particular box, or you can go to the uploaded. Now uploaded section will show all the videos that you have uploaded in your channel. So this is one of the videos that we had uploaded in one of the in module 3, where we saw how to work with YouTube. So we have uploaded a video, and then select the video. So the video will be placed in this particular box. You can increase the size of this, and you can have some content related to this video. So just say for example, services as the title. You can justify how you want to keep the text alignment. So I'll say justify the text, or you can keep it left align or right align as you want, or it can be center align. Then you can type in some more details of about other apps. So you can have a description, this video, Google. We have created two pages here. So now here the navigation of your pages is at the top. So as you click on this menus, you will see the pages are changing. Now we'll just have a preview. So just click on preview, and at the top you can see you have got modules. This is your home page. So this was the landing page of your website, and click on module 1. This will take you to the module 1 page. So this is another page that we have linked with our website. You can also go through the other layouts. So here you can see there's a menu. So when you click on home, you will be taken to the home page. Again, when you click on module 1, you will be taken to the module 1 page. So you can share your website with anyone. The person with whom you are sharing the website needs to have the link of your website. So just now you can close the preview. Now as you see here, the navigation of our web page is at the top. You can change this navigation pattern. So when you move your cursor to the title bar here, you can see there is a wheel appearing here. So this is a wheel, setting wheel. So you can click on this wheel, and you can change the navigation mode. So whether you want to have top navigation, so right now it is top navigation. You can also keep it as side navigation. So when you click on side navigation, you will see there is a side navigation bar. So this is what is appearing here, and you can change this accordingly. So side navigation bar appears. So if you want to keep it or you want to close it. So this is how the side navigation appears. Again we will have a preview of this. So click on preview. So you can see on the left side you have a side navigation, and by clicking on this you can change the page. So this is the home page and this is the module. So in this way you can share the e-content with the students. So not only for e-content, you can create your portfolio and you can share the link of this website. Now before sharing the link of the website, you need to publish your website. So this website needs to be published. So publishing is making it available to everyone. So after you design the entire website, you can click on publish. So here you can see there is a publish button. Click on the publish button and it will ask you for the web address. So here you can specify the web address. Say for example, I'll say, so you need to select the web address because the keywords may be used by somebody else. So you'll have to select the keywords by typing and just checking whether it is available or not. So you can click on publish. So now the site has been published. Now you can share your site with anyone. So say you can go to your home page. So click on the home page. So this is what is your landing page of your website. So by going to the home page, so the first page that you want to display when users access your page, so you click on the copy published link. So it will copy the link site. So this is what is the link site of your website. So copy link. Now this link can be sent to anybody and you can share it with anyone. So say for example, I'll share the link with, now I'll check whether I have received the, so whoever user you are sharing this link can access your website. So you need to practice these things in order to use this service. I'll show you what I had done with Google site. Yeah, you can see the mail has been received. And directly this is what is the landing page, the home page and module 1. So in this way you can have multiple web pages and create your own web page. So here I have shared the file, so you can see the file has been shared. Okay, so this is how we create a website. I'll show you what you can do with Google Sites. I have created a site wherein I am sharing the e-content with students. So I have prepared some notes for students and shared this with others, all students. So I have a navigation bar. So this is how it appears. So when you preview the site, so unit 1, so various topics in unit 1 and the subtopics. You click on this, you get the page for it. So this is how you can create the e-content and share with the students. So you can create your own web page, own website and share the website with others. So these are the references section. So whatever web pages I have accessed, I have used for preparing this content. So this is how we can create our own website and share the content, or create a e-journal, create video journal or portfolio. So all these things can be done using Google Sites. So Google Site is the best service for creating web pages or websites. I hope you'd like the video. Thanks for watching the video. So see you in the next module.